Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on Blender. And in this video we are going to see how we can use light and how it's possible to add light in Blender and to set the different parameters of the light. Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you like the content. First link on the description, the complete course Blender is available, so if you want to learn this software step by step with a curve structure, this curve would be perfect. It is a curve for beginners who want to arrive to advanced levels. A lot of hours of training content to perfectly master Blender for 3D modeling. So it is on the first link on the description, the complete guide on Blender. So let's start. Something that I'm going to do is to click on the cube and delete this cube. And this video will be perfect for people who want to start with light and how it's possible to set the light. Let's just click on add first mesh and we will select the monkey face, and this monkey face I will press R Z to just drag and move a little bit with 90 degrees here on the Z axis. And I will move a little bit the monkey face here on this area. Zoom a little bit and I will scale also with a value of 2 on the X axis, 2 on the Y axis and 2 on the Z axis, just like this. After to do this work, I will go on the right, modifiers, add modifiers, generate, and what I will use, I will just use the subdivision surface modifiers. And after to use the subdivision surface modifiers, I will increase the number of level with 4 and 3 for the render. And I will apply my modifiers. After I will go in the shading mode and I will just apply one materials on this monkey face. And for this, I will go on new to create a new principal BSDF. Something that I will do to create a small effect, I will go right click add. And I will select first a texture and we will use the Musgrave texture. And I will go right click, add, and I will select converter color ramp. So thanks to that, if I link the height to the FEC and the color to the base color of my principal BSDF, I can for my Musgrave texture define a first color. So I will define a first color like something like orange. And I will define my second color clicking on this print, and I will define something little like yellow, just like this. And after something that I will do, let's take the first one, and maybe I can make something little darker. And after that, I can work with the scale value. So here, if I need, I can change my value with the scale value, just like this. Let's decrease, maybe close to zero, it will be perfect. And after that, something that I will do is to increase the metallic value, for example, and decrease the roughness. So it's okay for that. Let's just come back to the layout mode. And inside the layout mode, you can find the light on this area. To have access to your light, you need to click on the shading, the render shadings. And as you can see, we don't have too much power on this light, but first I want to set the camera. So I will click on my camera, clicking here and just set the position of my camera first, and I will go on the object option and change the position of the camera. Let's work with a location. Y axis I will work more here, Z axis maybe around this area, and I will create then a rotation on my Z axis, maybe like this, and let's just change on the Y axis, go more on this area and turn again on the Z axis, just here. So it's okay for that. I can use my data object property, reduce a little bit the focal length. Let's work with maybe this type of focal length. And here we can have a view, for example, on the monkey face. Let's drag and move a little bit. And we can use, for example, this view for the render. Maybe I can select the monkey face, drag and move a little bit, just here, and select one more time my camera. And on the options, object property, I will work a little bit on the Z axis, just here. So it's okay for that. Let's just come back. So by default, if I just click here, you have a light. This light you can drag and move. Not using this, you can press G, and when you press G, you can drag and move the light. If you press Z, you can constrain on the Z axis, X on the X axis. If you press G, oops, I just click on the light, G, X, and you can constrain on the X axis, and G, Y, you can constrain on the Y axis. You can also use the object property data to change the position on the light on the different axes, as you can see. Here you have the scale value, but it's not very important in this case. If you want to add a light, you can go on Add, and you select light, and you have multiple type of light, but you can change point for sun, spot, or area after. If I select point, I can add a second light here. I can press G, Z, and position, for example, G, Y, and I can create a second point light if I want. If I wanted one more, I can go and add light. I can select a point again. I can press G and I can drag and move this light. So you can create 3-point light if you need, but here is not what we are going to do. Here I have one basic light, point, and another point. Let's just remove this one with delete and remove this one with delete, and let's just come back with this basic light. If you want to have access to the property, you need to go here, Object Data Properties. And in the Object Data Properties, something that you can do is to increase the power first, because here we don't have too much power. So if I tap 4000, I can obtain this render. If I tap 20000, as you can see, it's different. Don't hesitate to use your camera view. So thanks to that, you can see the render at the end. So in this case, maybe I can try 8000 to obtain this render. You can change the color. By default, the color is in white, but you can change a little bit the color. And if you create something like a green color, as you can see, you have a green effect directly for your element. Let's just come back with a white color. You can decrease a little bit diffuse. You have also specular, so the way on how the light will be reflected directly on the face of my object. And you have also some volume, but here you won't have too many change. You can increase a little bit the radius. If you increase a little bit the radius, you will see some change about the shadows here. At any moment, if you want to deactivate the shadows, you can just deactivate here the view of the shadows. But generally, we keep the shadows. And that's it. So now if you create a render, you go on the render option, you will have your camera view just like this. So you click on render, render image. And after to click on render image, I will see if I zoom little out, up, just the render of my monkey face. Here we don't have anything on the background and with the light. So if you don't use the light, you won't see anything. If you don't have any light on the scene or a HDRI environment to have, for example, a natural light, it's not going to be possible to see anything on your render. So this is the base. In Blender, you have your conception, and in each conception, you need to set a camera, and you need to set a light also to be able to create a render. If I just go on the right, you have also some options you can change for area, spot, and sun. Sun is little specific, you can decrease, but here it's going to be very strong, even if you can decrease the power, just like this. Or you can press G and you can drag and move so you can have the churn effect. You can select a spot, very interesting in interior scene. So it means you can change the direction of your spot. First, when you go in this area, you can extend the circle view, just like this. And you can also drag and move your spot to change the location. So it is something interesting to know. So you can take your light here, and you can press G to position your light. And after, you can select the arrow, and with the arrow, you can change the location on the spot just like this. And it is interesting because you can just drag and move, change the position of your spot. Something that I'm going to do is to press G, position maybe here. And after to do this work, I can change the power. And I can increase with 8000. And now I will have spot render. And if I click here, the render will be a little different than if I use the point. So this is the point, and we have the spot. And if you select area, it's one more time a little bit different, for the simple reason that one more time you have this point, just like this. And if you select area, you can extend a little bit here. You can arrive on this area and you can create a frame. and this frame will allow you to create a light. So when you go here, you can extend the frame and the light will work directly inside this rectangle. So it is a complete area that you can use to add your light. So this is the point light and this is the area light for the simple reason that we have a frame, as you can see, and we have extended this frame. Every time you can drag and move on this direction or drag and move on this direction. And when you are satisfied, I'm going to come back to the point. Maybe I can turn, press G, turn a little bit, position the light here, maybe like this, and I can go on render and render image. So it's okay for that. We are going to stop here for this video on how to create a light on Blender. If you like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channels. First link on the description, the complete course Blender is available. So if you want to learn this software step by step with a course structure, this course will be perfect. A lot of hours of training content to see all the features of Blender every time with concrete example. Perfect course structure to directly increase the levels. And even if you have a beginner levels in Blender, at the end of this course, you will have an advanced level. First link on the description, Blender, the complete guide. And for the next video, see you. Ciao, ciao.